I've got it figured.
You do?
I've had two separate folks tell me there've been strangers around these parts last couple nights. Can't tell what they look like, because they're staying in the shadows, covert-like. Nobody's been hurt, mind you. And that's the giveaway.
I see.
It's called probing. It's a military procedure. You send out a reconnaissance group, very small, check things out. Not to engage, but to evaluate the situation. Evaluate the level of danger. Make sure things are all clear.
Clear for what?
For the rest of them.
Very ominous, that there intro right there. Welcome to the sewers of Brooklyn, New York, everybody. This is Nick the Rat Radio, the only podcast that is broadcast from the sewer, I guess. I'm Nick the Rat, and this is radio. Tonight is episode 165. It is February 13th. Tomorrow is Valentine's Day. So make sure you put on a nice, sexy robe for this episode. It helps. We will be drinking gin tonight. Hold on, I gotta make my drink right in here. Can't just pop open a bottle of gin and start swigging. So I'm gonna do one part gin. Pour that in here. Oh, that's a healthy splash. We're gonna do. Hey, why not make it a little fancy with some coconut water of some sort? Yeah, we're gonna throw some coconut water in there with some gin. All right, that's nice, that's good. And then to give it the little bubbly and that good old extra flavor, and we're gonna use some ginger ale. So yeah, that's the drink of the evening, which will be hard to make later. Probably not, we'll see. Tonight's episode is a special episode. I was actually at a blank. I didn't know what to do for this episode. I was drawing a blank. I usually never draw a blank, so I was a little scared. But I got an email from an actual scientist. It's not gross, Cyborg Dave. If that's what you're if you're talking about my drink, it's good. Let me just take a swig right here. It's good. It's tasty. So I didn't know what to do for the episode tonight, but luckily I got an email from a scientist. Now, when you get an email from a scientist, you don't take it not seriously. You don't take it lightly. You take it seriously. And he was telling me that he has proof that the Fresno Nightwalker is real. He's a scientist. He knows how it happened. He sent an email documenting how it happened. And there's even a clip. He sent the noise that it made. So I'm really, really excited to get into this episode, basically, because I only read the title of the email. I don't like to spoil anything. So, it just said they're a scientist. It was also from, an EDU website, so I know they're real. And they said they have proof about the Fresno Nightcrawler. Now, I didn't really know what it was. I didn't really want to look into it that much, but I looked into it. If you're on the Twitch channel, you can see it. There's a video clip of it running around, but I'll get into exactly what it probably is. I'll get into the email. These are spoilers. I'm sorry, everybody. But, you know, there's also going to be phone calls. There's going to be news. There's going to be advertisements, because even though I love my donators, people that donate and sponsor the show, I just want to say thank you to all of you, because you know who you are. You're awesome. I should maybe make like a list of people that donate, but I don't know if you want your name out there. Maybe you want to do it in private. But if you actually do ever send donations to me, just send a note, and I'll basically do anything you want me to do. It's kind of true. I've done some things I regret. No, I'm joking. I never regretted any of it. We're going to jump right back into the show, the episode, this fun time. And usually we started off with some music. So let's play a little Maestro 2.0 with Resting State. Let's see what this is all about. This seems like it could be a good old song right here. And the show will continue. Fresno Nightcrawler, everybody. It's Wednesday. I almost spilt my drink all over.
Nick on the No Agenda stream.
Absolutely. Live, baby. Yeah. Kidding me? Even you listen to Nick the Rat.
I have listened.
Anyway, the point of the segment was, you typically would wind up by saying, wow, corporate media sucks. Podcasting's where it's at.
Astro 2.0, Resting State. That's some good stuff right there. I like that one a lot. That's a good song. Get you in the mood for dancing? I don't know. I can't dance. I'm sitting down doing a show. Rocking out of my recorder, though. So Fresno is a place in California, if you didn't know. It's 112 square miles in the center of the San Joaquin Valley. It's a southern portion of the California's Central Valley. It's founded in 1872. But we're not really here to talk about California. We're here to talk about the Fresno Nightcrawler. Now, let me just get right into the email. Let me just go to the email. We'll start it off there. That I got, and we'll just jump right into this. All right, so let me open this up here. All right, it says, "Hello, Nick. I heard your show, and I feel your platform might be the right outlet for me to release this disturbing information." I guess it's probably a good one. The public needs to know, and I hope you will spread the word. I work in a lab at SCU Fresno Physics Department. Oh, he's a physicist. This has to be real. And recently, while studying particle and quantum physics, it seems we have made a dimensional tear in the fabric of space-time. A beautiful blue radiant portal opened in the middle of our lab. Holy. This is going to change the world, people. This is some stuff that doesn't happen every day. This is... Yeah, my nipples are a little hard. A beautiful blue radiant portal opened up in the middle of our lab and let out a strange hum. This is great that this is coming out on my show first. I'm going to get a lot of ratings. I can't go into all the details because you and your listeners probably wouldn't understand them. Come on, try us. Jeez. Anyways, either way, it involved a massive amount of energy and lasers. All right. The strange thing was that a creature, it was all white and sort of resembled a clothing pin. It was around 4 feet. 4 feet high. And it came walking out of the portal. This is chilling information right here. If that happened to me, I'd probably just turn it off and leave. It looked just like images I have seen on something called it. Wait, it looked just like images I've seen of something called the Fresno Nightcrawler that I recall seeing on security footage from 2007. Actually, if you go to my Twitch channel, I think that's what I have running right now. You could see that footage there. And if that is what it looks like, this is shocking information, people. I don't know how you could just say that there's some stuff like this going on and not tell everybody. We were able to record it, but since you're just doing an audio show, I thought I'd send you a sound recording of it. Well, that's nice of you. It seemed friendly enough, so when I went over to touch it, it turned and walked back into the portal, and it instantly closed. Whoa. So that means it was, like, sentient. It knew. It knew what was going on. We haven't been able to replicate the experiment again, but we need to let people know the truth. Please play the audio for your audience so they will finally know that the Fresno Nightcrawler is real, and it's from another dimension. Thank you for your courage, Dr. G. Freeman. All right. Let me see if I can... Where's this clip? Hold on, let me get the clip here. Dr. G. Freeman, and he was... What school was that? What CSU Fresno Psychic... Physics, not Psychics Department. That'd be cool if there was a... Hold on 1 second. Let me just get this clip loaded here. All right, here we go, everybody. Let's listen to this, and we're going to listen to this thing. Let's hear what it sounds like. I think we just made history. That's the first recording from a being from another dimension. I guess that hum in the background was the lasers because it was intense energy and stuff. Hold on, let me play that again. Let me just play that one again really quick because that sound, that was pretty chilling. I don't know if I'd try to touch this thing. I don't know if I'd try to touch it. Can I get it louder? Let me see if I can make it louder here. Oh my god, no. Go back into the portal. I would not want to be around that thing. That is scary. I need to relax a little bit. I don't think we really need to hear that. That was... So the Fresno Nightcrawler is from another dimension. They're saying it's about 4 feet tall. It's white. And judging by the security camera footage that I'm seeing, it like wobbles. And you heard what it sounded like. That was... Okay, let me go to my voicemail line, see if there's any good voicemails to play here. Wait, where's my voicemail line? Is this it? Voicemail. Yeah, this is it. 917-719-5923. If you want to call right now and leave a message about what you think about what you just heard, oh boy, just give me a call, because I'm shook. I'm a little creeped out. I didn't even think this thing didn't even look like it had a mouth or something, but that sounded like it came from a mouth to me. Like it, I don't know. Let's see. What is the voice?
Nick the Rat. Still water's rock again.
Is this from like a masseuse parlor or something? Masseuse parlor?
Call that number and speak your mind. Not right now, though. It's too loud in here. Too loud in here.
Yep, 917.
Jeez. Caller, if you're going to call me, make sure you're not sitting on your phone, okay? Try not to butt dial me. This might be a better voicemail. Let's try another voicemail, because that was, sad to say, it was a little bit of a letdown, whoever that was, Mr. Butt Dialer. 917-719-5923. Whoa, this is a long voicemail. I could tell from the transcription. Hey, let's load it up and listen.
Nick the Rat. Nick the Rat. Nick the Rat. Nick the Rat. The Rat. Nick 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 the Rat.
Yeah.
Well, this is Tony the Wolf.
Oh, man.
And that was my funky, funky bass remix of the name of your show. You can hear that song playing at clubs everywhere throughout the East Coast, especially right here in New York City. Nick the Rat, I saw that one of your previous episodes was titled Santa's Secret Base. And I just wanted to let you know that I recently came into some very special, confidential, classified information.
Really?
Regarding Santa's secret base.
I thought it blew up.
Where does Santa live throughout the year? It might not just be the North Pole. There might be other places that Santa and his elves and maybe even the Greys, where do they live together? Maybe it's the North Pole. Maybe because of the reverse polarity of the Earth's magnetic field, maybe they also have a secret base and a complex, if you will, on the South Pole.
I didn't think about that.
And maybe, something no one has ever considered, what if Santa has a secret undersea base, like a James Bond villain, an underwater base, right around the equator? Because you think about it, Santa, he doesn't want to be in the cold all year. You know, he's gotta have some temperature variation to regulate his bloodstream. So Santa, I think he took a decommissioned base from a James Bond villain that was underwater in the late 1970s. A decommissioned base underwater at the equator, where his elves and the Greys and the DMT machine elves, they hang out, they have parties, they gather the supplies for the coming Christmas toy season. Should look into that. I think there's a couple good websites about Santa having a presence at the North Pole and the South Pole, and also at the equator. You heard it here first from Tony Wolf.
My man, Tony Wolf, enlightening us right here. I didn't even think about this. There could be another base on the South Pole, and possibly at the equator, too. Like, you know, hey, why not? You know, a little summer vacation home. Tony, that's actually mind-altering. Thank you for that call, Tony. We'll be out. Wow, I can already tell the show is gonna be very long, from all the voicemails that I have here. But we're gonna continue on with the show. You know, maybe I should play a Zindu right now. You know what? Sorry. Let's skip Zindu right now. We're going to play a little bit more of those clips later, but I really need to maybe listen to some music right now. And we got my man Akira, with Ninja Gaiden 4-2 theme. Akira remix. Check it out. That was Akira with Ninja Gaiden. 4-2 theme. That's good stuff by Akira. I love him. He's great. Ah! He's a good dude. Ooh. Happy Vagina Day. It's, actually, you know what? It is, it's going to be Valentine's Day in about 30 minutes for me. It's 11:30 in Brooklyn, New York right now. I usually do open the phone lines up at 11:30, but I did, more or less I opened up after the third song. So you got to wait for one more song before I open up the phone lines. We have a lot of show to get to. It's going to run long tonight. I might be up till about 6, 7 in the morning. Nah, not that late. But let's play a little something about love. Why not, you know? What should we start off with? Should we start it off thick or thin? Let's start it off, you know, let's run off of what we did last week. We did a lot of Alan Watts last week. Let's continue with Alan Watts. I only have one more from him this week. The rest are from other great thinkers. But here's an Alan Watts clip talking about love. Then we're going to get back into the show about the Fresno Nightcrawlers. And what are they here for? What do they want? Shoes? Maybe.
Well, now, really, when we go back then to falling in love and say it's crazy, falling, you see, we don't say rising into love. There is in it the idea of the fall. And goes back, as a matter of fact, to extremely fundamental things, that there is always a curious tie at some point between the fall and the creation, taking this ghastly risk is the condition of there being life. You see, for all, the life is an act of faith and an act of gamble. The moment you take a step, you do so on an act of faith, because you don't really know that the floor is not going to give under your feet. The moment you take a journey, what an act of faith. The moment you enter into any kind of human undertaking and relationship, what an act of faith. See, you've given yourself up. But this is the most powerful thing that can be done. Surrender. See, and love is an act of surrender to another person. Total abandon. I give myself. Take, do anything you like. So, that's quite mad, because you see, it's letting things get out of control. All sensible people keep things in control. Watch it, watch it, watch it. Security, vigilance, watch it. Police, watch it. Guards, watch it. Who's going to watch the guards? So, actually, therefore, the course of wisdom, what is really sensible, is to let go, is to commit oneself, to give oneself up, and that's quite mad. So we come to the strange conclusion that in madness lies sanity.
Alan, what's you trying to say? He's fun to listen to. I really dug his last episode. I play things that I like, and I like that. So let me just throw that clip into the garbage. Pop, and we're ready to continue on with the show. And I think I feel it. I feel it in my bones. It's time for Zindu. Cue up the Zindu. Kyle. Kyle, pick your bones up off the floor, Kyle. So many of his bones are decaying. I need to glue them back together with some paper mache or something. All right, Kyle, you can't do it, Kyle? All right, I'll hit the button for you. You want me to... And the best part about Kyle being dead is I don't have to pay him anymore. So, Zindu.
Hey, everybody. Yeah, it's me, Zindu. Looks like Allison Mack's back in the news. Yeah, I'm still on that there. It looks like they kept some lady locked up in a room for 2 years because she's fucking somebody that wasn't her master or something. I don't know. There's all these allegations, sex trafficking. What else do they have that these people are? I don't know, a whole bunch of stuff. Let's see here. Blah, 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 blah. Identity theft. Harboring of aliens for financial gain. They didn't harbor me. Only Nick the Rat does that, and it's for financial gain too.
Not true. I don't
harbor. Extortion, forced labor, sex trafficking, money laundering, wire fraud, and obstruction of justice. All I know is that one day this is going to make a great TV movie. I can't wait to watch it and find out what actually is happening over here. Somebody said that there's this guy out there named Frank Report that was doing a lot of coverage on it. But he, in an article from February 13th on his webpage, he talks about like Comic-Con and how she's not going to show up because she was a sex slaver. But then at the end of the article, he writes, if she's acquitted or when, if convicted, she emerges from prison, it is hoped Allison will return to the Comic-Con convention circuit. If he's so against her, why is he hoping that she comes back to the Comic-Con convention circuit? Does he want to be abducted by her, too? I don't know. I wouldn't mind it. She's kind of cute, you know. Anyway, this is Zindu on his continuing coverage of the sex cults. I don't fucking know what it's called anymore. It's like NXIVX, Nixivixum, or some shit. I don't know. Yeah. Sounds like a whole bunch of weirdos. I don't know. Do they have guns and weapons? How do they keep these people locked up? I can't wait for the TV story to come out because there's so many questions I can't find the answer to. Well, probably because it's still in court, I guess. But we'll find out one day. It's gonna be a great TV series. I've got my lotion and my tissues ready. Oh, my little geez. Wet naps. Can't wait. Anyway, this is Zindu for the Dark Super Network News.
I'm gonna check Zindu to see if he's got one of those brandings on him. It sounds like he was involved in this sex. He brings it up all the goddamn time. If you send an email to nick@nicktherat.com and you put... Hold on one second. Sorry, the ginger ale is coming back up. If you go to nick@nicktherat.com and you put the thing as hashtag gas blast, or just write gas blast in the thing, I'll read it. Let me just check my email and see if I have any gas blasts. I burped at the appropriate time, I guess, right? How do we gas blast? Get it? Huh? We'll be opening up the phone lines after the next song. Running a little late already. Oh, wait. What is this? There we go. Looks like we have a gas blast. Okay. Gas blast. Hey, Nick, I was wondering if you could be my Valentine. Oh. That's so sweet. I already have like 4 or 5 of them. Man, I might be able to squeeze you in. You know, what is a Valentine anyway? You know, I love everybody. I love subscribers. I love non-subscribers. I love listeners. I love haters too. If you hate Nick the Rat, I love you. Let's see. Let me finish this email here. Hey, Nick, I was wondering if you could be my Valentine. I seem to have bad luck with guys. Well, have you tried men? everyone that I date seem to go missing. They wind up on the news and are usually found dead. I also wake up with blood under my nails sometimes. Not my blood. I'm just gonna stop reading that there. And yeah, I'm filled to the brim. I'm filled to the brim with Valentine. I can't. No. No. Let's go to a song. You know, actually, maybe we have a lot of voicemail. Let's play one more voicemail, and then we'll go to a song, and then we'll open up the phone line. Otherwise, we'll never get to the end of the show here. 917-719-5923. 423. Let's try this voicemail right here.
Yeah, it's Frufu Man, and like that sound of that Fresno nightcrawler sounds like me after taking a great big bloody shit. So there.
Oh boy.
Fur out, man. Meow for now.
The bark at the end. All right. We got a song. All the music, by the way, is on SoundCloud. You could go to My Likes, Nick the Rat, one word. I think it's SoundCloud/Likes/Nick the Rat. You can go to my website and find it there somehow. Click all the links. I've been getting hits on No Agenda Social saying that my site is red. It's probably because it's not HTTPS. I'm not getting any information from you anyway. If you click donate on my site, though, there's a donation button. If you like what you hear, if you feel like you have been expanded in your mind. The Loyalist, Socialized Pepsi. That's great. Cheers.
Chinook Center's biggest promotion ever, the Frequent Shopper Program. Together with CFCN Television, the Calgary Sun, and QR77, Chinook Center brings you Pepsi giveaways daily.
Yeah, motherfucker, I thought I told you one time, I'll tell you 16 times. Stop blasting that monkey bullshit up from the sewer. You're trampling my HS signals out of Mexico. I can't get my slave labor codes made. I can't get my signal down there because you're trampling my motherfucking signal. I can hear that shit coming up to my...
Good morning to you, sir. Nick the Rock.
I just gotta let you know right now, man, you're doing great stuff, and I fucking love you, man, your show rocks. Nick the Rat!
That was the Loyalist, Socialized Pepsi. I'm getting reports in the chat that gin is bullshit. It is just distilled through juniper. It's still alcoholic, isn't it? No, whatever. That's all I really care about. So, haha, do when dum dum dum. The more I drink, the more I'll know. Hey, it's us, Tundin, in the chat. Okay, we can't talk about the chat all night. All right, I'm going to read... Wait... What is this? Before I open up the phone line, which I'm going to do in a minute, we're at that point. I like rum too. But we're going to, what is, whoa. We just got another, this is a weird email. This one says important. Read now. Let me read this now. Hi, Nick. That's me. I just heard you talking about the Fresno Nightcrawler. And boy, oh boy, was that guy wrong. Are you talking about Dr. G. Freeman? He's a doctor. How could he be wrong? The Nightcrawler is from this dimension, so he's not interdimensional. I was out one night with some buddies at Belmont Memorial Park. I'm guessing that's in California or something. And the sky lit up with a deep blue color. I'm going to say this forever, aren't I? I sometimes you have speech impediments, okay? We saw a ball of light hit the surface of the grass and hover there. This is getting serious. Hold on. Where was I? This fake ass gin. Maybe I'm fake. I don't know. No, I'm not. I'm real. Let's see here. The ball of light vanished, and we didn't see anything after that. I whipped out my camera phone, but after we didn't see anything, so I put it down. I faced it towards the grass. That's when we heard it. Oh my god. When we turned around to look, and sure enough, hold on one second. They didn't see something, and then they turned and they saw something. I see. So the ball of light came, it vanished. They didn't see anything. They turned around, they heard a noise, they looked back, and they saw something. It was about 3 feet tall. It looked like... I'm going to read this because it said important on there. It looked like two tampons were tied together, wobbling around in the grass. As soon as we saw it, you spelt that wrong there, caller, writer, emailer. As soon as we saw it, it glimmered and vanished, but we still heard it. Then we saw the ball of light reappear, and it flew off into the night sky. Love the show. Don't let people spread lies. Thanks, Dutch. Dutch, that's a cool name. P.S. I attached the audio clip of what we heard. Well, here we go, people. Let me load this up. How can I get this over here? Let me put that there. Let me load this clip in. All right. I usually don't do this. I usually don't play things on the fly, but... All right, after we do this email, this can't be real. Can this be real? This might be real. I don't know. Let's play it, listen to it. And then I'll open up the phone line and we'll take calls. Do you think it's real? Give me a call. 917-719-5923. We're going to play this clip now. I also would like to... before I play this clip, if you have young people listening to this show right now, you might want to move them into another room. Because... This can give them nightmares. Like, if there's really interdimensional alien creatures on this planet, your kids might not want to know about this. Okay. Enough suspense. Let's play the clip. Sounds like rain.
Look here.
What the fuck?
What the hell is it?
Holy did you guys hear that? That was creepy as fuck. Intergalactic bong, really, Radex? It's not a bullfrog. I've heard bullfrogs, I've heard bongs. That was out of worldly. That was, okay. Let's play that again. It's from a guy named Dutch. Let me bump the volume up on there. Let's just play it as loud as possible. We're going to play it again. Sounds like he's in a rainy park. He's in the park. I don't know where it is, but I think I mentioned it before. Here we go. What the hell? Okay, the clip is dying. Is my whole stream dying? I don't know. Let me reload the clip. Let me reload that. Oh. I put the phone down on the back key. Yeah, Jin's fake. It's fake. Let's reload the clip. Pump it up. There we go.
Look at it. What the hell is it?
That's creepy. That's creepy.
Look at it. Look at it. What the hell is it?
I don't want to know. You know what? I don't. All right, we're going to open the phone lines. Taking the do not disturb off. 917-719-5923. If you'd like to call me, talk about the Fresno fucking nightcrawler. Could be an alien. Could be a interdimensional creature. Give me a call. Until then, let's listen to a voicemail.
I'm feeling lucky. Spin that wheel of mayo for me.
I okay. Let's spin the wheel of mail. Let's see if we have any emails. Hashtag, not a hashtag, just sewer blast. Gas blast. God damn it. Whoa, we got like a couple in here. These just appeared. People are really excited about this. I got a lot of listeners. So we got to let you know there's like thousands of people listening right now. Live. All right, let's get this last gas blast right here. Gas blast. I'm not going to read your name, so don't put your name in the email. Just, I'm not going to read that. So, blank. Do you know those chocolate balls with the red cherries inside? What other color would they be, sir? I kind of gave away your name. Now you know it's a sir. Do you know the chocolate balls with... Yeah, I love those. It's the little cherries in there, right? That's pretty good. Are those actual testicles? Just wondering. No, they're cherries, sir. Sir, they're fucking cherries, okay? Don't try to ruin this shit for me. I like those things, okay? And you come all up in here just trying... We got a phone call. Got a lot of callers on the line. Hello, caller!
Hello. Hi. So, I've got a question for you, Nick.
Sure.
Okay, so, out of curiosity, like I was saying in Twitch, if the email that you read off earlier said that the Fresno Nightcrawler was about 4 feet tall, yeah, would it or could it possibly be related to the Carmel area creature?
The Carmel area creature?
Mm-hmm. That is correct.
Where's the Carmel area? Is that, like, between the thighs?
No, that would actually be down in California.
Oh, huh. I don't know what this Carmel area creature is. Maybe let me do a quick look. I could do a quick look. Are there pictures of them on the internet?
Actually, it's also going to show the same video if you look at the right website. But they're saying that the Carmel creature is 7 feet tall, not 4 feet.
Holy shit, you're right. That looks exactly the same. Maybe mm-hmm. maybe it just grew. Maybe it was walking from Fresno, and once it makes it to Carmel, it's bigger.
Okay, that would be an interesting thought. Didn't even think about that.
Well, you come on, caller. You got to use your whoa. There's a picture of it. Could be a deer walking on its hind legs.
Or like it says here, what about a gazelle standing upright? Who knows?
Deer, gazelle. That's what I'm seeing. I don't think it's that. It's definitely an alien.
There's shit going on.
There's no way it could be a gazelle walking from Fresno to Carmel. Carmel? Do you say Carmel or Carmel?
Carmel.
Carmel?
Oh, I call it Carmel, but it's probably called Carmel. I was born in California. We just got out of there as fast as we could.
So did you ever see this creature?
No, but I did see my sister quite a lot. She looks remarkably like it.
I like ladies with long legs.
Yeah, we're just not quite sure about the rest of her.
Well, do you think this creature is an alien or an interdimensional creature being, or do you think it's like just a deer on his back legs, gazelle?
When I first saw it, I thought of the compass that we used to draw circles back in grade school.
True, it does. That's what you're saying.
A chip. Yeah, I don't know what to blame it on, but it just looks like a walking compass.
It kind of does look like a compass. I do see it's just two long legs. It's just like some weird looking creature. It's very strange looking.
Or somebody on stilts and they just photoshopped the upper body on.
Well, no. Well, every report of this creature is saying that it's really small, like 24 to 48 inches. It's a little bigger than me, but that's about it.
I'll keep that in mind then. But that was all. That's all I wanted to ask.
Is there anything you'd like to say to hashtag sewer chat before I let you go?
Yes. Okay.
Nope. You can't. You're telling me you shouldn't talk bad about your sister. Family comes first, and unless it's on your lover. We have a more songs or something. What do we have? We should play an advertisement because we have to make money down here in the sewer to keep the show going. And we have another phone call coming in. We're just going to go to the next phone call. Hello, caller.
Hi, Nick. How are you?
I'm doing pretty good tonight. How are you?
Not great. You know why? I have two problems. I have two problems that I need to discuss. One, I accidentally smoked way too much weed, so I'm not sure if I can actually read the story.
Oh, my God. Is this the storyteller, Illuminati?
Yeah. I had a rough day, so I smoked weed to feel better, and then I got too high, I overdid it.
Oh, man. Can you just make it up and pretend that you could read?
Well, hold up. I have another idea. Oh. It came to me. I was like, whoa.
Listen. That works.
So, right now, let's see, where did we stop?
The last thing I remember was the dog going into the cave.
Yeah. So she was like, "Woe is me, why is my father kidnapped?" Right? So, here's the point where it could be like a sad tax story for tax season.
Taxes. It's coming up, everybody. April, what is it, April 20th?
Something like that.
Maybe.
So, okay, here's the other idea I had. Well, I didn't have a first idea. So here's my idea. I am stuck in my story. I'm at a point where I'm like, okay, did she sneak into the cave? But like, how like boring would it be if she just like went in and saved her father? Is the end of the story, roll credits? What if I had the listeners do like a choose your own adventure type of thing? Huh. Like maybe, I don't know, I think it'd be cool. Like, maybe I can put some kind of poll on Twitter or something and, like, give them a bunch of options, and then whatever gets the most votes, like, I'll write it into this story.
This works for me, because I don't have to do any work for it. This is on you.
Yeah, so I'll just put it out there with the people that are listening right now.
I've heard some theories. I've heard some theories about the story.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Do you want to know what I've heard?
Go on.
I heard that the dog was her father. I heard that.
Okay.
I heard that there was a witch or something and changed the dad into a dog. This is what I heard.
Oh. Okay.
I don't know who said this, but somebody said it. I read it and it stuck with me because I thought that was it. It sounded legit.
Sounds pretty. Yeah. You know what? I can go with that for sure.
The dog father? I think you got that backwards there, right?
She's like, Dad! he like pisses on a tree.
She disowns him. No father of mine pisses on a tree. Actually, I think every man alive has probably peed on a tree. It's not. Actually, maybe every human. Have you ever peed on a tree?
Yeah.
See, yeah, it's true. Every human has peed on a tree. The things that give us life and oxygen, we just pee on them.
We just pee on them. We cut them down. We turn them into toothpicks.
It's so weird. You know? Life is strange. It's like the things that keep us alive, we treat like toilets. But hey, I respect my toilet. I think the toilet is probably the most sacred thing I have in my house, my sewer.
I am pretty particular with the cleanliness of my toilet. Huh. They have to be clean or else I'm disgusted. That's weird. I shouldn't talk about this on the show.
No, it's fine. It's fine. I'm very curious about toilet cleaning because it's important. It's a natural thing. See, the weird thing about life is a lot of things happen and people feel like they can't talk about it. Like we can't talk about how clean I keep my toilet. Some people don't keep a clean toilet, and when I go to their house, I'm like, "How do you live? How are you alive? How do you do this?"
That's like the worst thing. Like, I'm really tempted to like excuse myself and go home and pee. Like, wow. I cannot stand.
Well, you
I
have to sit
stand
on it. Yeah,
a dirty fucking toilet.
It's pretty bad.
It's like, why? What is your problem? Like, do you just like want to sit on your filth? Like, ew.
Oh, snap. happy Valentine's Day from New York, by the way.
Aw, happy Valentine's Day.
It just turned to, it just hit midnight here in New York.
Oh, wow. Happy midnight. Whoa, it's weird. It became midnight. I was on the phone then too.
You're a midnight caller.
That sounds kind of skanky.
I could hear like a Tom Waits song. She was a midnight caller. What a skanky VDs. Yeah, I could hear that. That's probably, could be a song.
That's so good. I can't do it.
you tried. That's all that really matters. So when you go, I have a question. When you go to somebody's house with a dysfunctional toilet, do you mention it to them or you don't mention it, do you?
Well, it depends on how close we are. Like, if we're close, I'm like, you're a disgusting fuck. Clean your toilet.
Well, the closer you are, the more
you can
say.
With you?
This is true.
Yeah.
What if...
It's weird. Like, the more I love people, the more I abuse them.
No, this makes sense. This makes sense. But what about a third party? Say you love somebody and their friend has a dirty toilet. Would you bring it up to them too, or does third party get the amount of love?
I'm not gonna lie. Like sometimes I'll talk shit, and that would be one of the things I talk shit about. Like, dude, your friend's toilet is fucking gross. Like, like, ew. Hey. It really is bad.
No, it is. It is. It's very because you use it daily. You put your genitalia next to it, so you're kind of like exposed to it. You don't need that. You don't need that near you. You don't need that near.
Ugh, no. Ew. And it's like, well, maybe it's because like I was a maid for a little bit, and I would clean toilets, and it was like, you have no idea.
You were a maid.
Yeah, for a bit.
Do you know what's weird? I would never hire a maid, and people think I'm weird for it.
Yeah, no, I was,
Would you hire a maid? You were a maid. Would you hire a maid?
If it were me, I'd hire me. Like, I was really good.
Well, we have to hire ourselves to clean our own houses, no matter what. That's usually
not...
No,
I don't get... I don't...
It's not the option.
I do it for free. I pay nothing for me. well, yeah, to clean my house.
But would you pay somebody?
Bitch.
Would you pay somebody to clean your house? I can never. I would never do that. Even if I was rich, if I was like a millionaire with like a mansion, I'd still do it myself.
Oh bullshit! You no. Clean a whole mansion? I would not. No, I would hire like 5 fucking cleaners.
I would get like a Roomba. I'd get a Roomba or something. I wouldn't
a
need
mansion.
A...
It has to be a pretty big ass Roomba. You'd need like a whole army of Roombas.
Why? That was if I'm a rich, I could have a Roomba per room. I wouldn't need a mansion if I was rich. I just need a closet with a computer. I live in the sewer, for crying out loud.
So you'd have a mansion in the sewer? That's pretty like you. I can imagine your mansion having like all empty rooms except for one.
And here is my guest room, and here's a guest room. They're all empty. If you don't like sitting on the floor, you're going to be a very unhappy guest. What's the point of it?
You're just like, it's like I asked you to bring up your blow-up bed.
I will not pay for that. I will not pay for a maid to clean these rooms for my guest. That stay
I've got,
here. Jeez.
I've got 20 acres of land. You can go get a tent.
That's what I would get. I would get like one room and a lot of land. I would just like have one room in the middle of a forest or something.
I could see that. Actually.
That would be pretty cool. It'd be a real high tech room. It would be.
Yeah, it'd be like your little Unabomber shack, like out in the middle of the woods.
But like a millionaire's Unabomber shack. It would be the most pimped. There'd be spinners on there and lasers coming off the roof and stuff.
Oh my god. I'm totally going all this for saying that, aren't I?
Maybe.
Yeah. Oh, wow. Well, I did write a little bit more story. I don't know. I think it sucks. Like, I'm just like, ugh. Because it's becoming too cliche. Yeah. And cliche is like, I don't want to be a basic bitch. I want to be non-cliche.
Are you enjoying the writing process?
You know, I am. And then I'm like, fuck. This sounds stupid. You know what I mean?
No, I do. That's why you have to do it live.
Oh, boy. Just like off the top of my head, just like.
Yeah. Sadly, I think the creative process is ruined by writing it down.
Really?
Which is weird, because how else could you be a writer if you don't write it down?
When I was working with kids, I would have story time, and I'd literally just sit down in a chair and just like tell a story about anything that came to mind, and they fucking loved it.
Well, yeah.
It was fun.
Well, it's kind of like I don't know if you ever played Dungeons and Dragons, but that's what Dungeon Master does.
Yeah.
They just do it. They just.
I know. Dude, there's just my. Okay, so I ref for Derby, you know. One of the head ref fucking guy is the best DM I've ever known. Like, he does, like, the voices and the breathe. I don't know. Anyway, it's fucking awesome.
So while he's breathing,
like,
nobody else does.
I'm a barbarian. Yeah, well, see, I'm a barbarian. So then when I go into, like, a rage, right?
Yeah.
He's just like, and like mimicking what I would be sounding like. I'm like, dude, I'm there.
Wait, so the DM is making the noises for you?
Yeah.
Your DM is a little, he's a what are they called? Not a sadist. He's got the whip. I wouldn't
what
let
if,
my DM
like,
make my
it's
noises.
Still cool.
If my DM was making noises for me, I'd be like, yo, DM, shut up. I got my noises down. I know what I sound like.
Well, he's really good, dude. Like, he would be a good storyteller. I wish I could make him call on the show.
Yeah, get him to call the show. I'm going to yell at him. I'm going to be like, make your players breathe. Because if you're the only one breathing at the table.
I know. I want to do the heavy breathing.
Oh, jeez. Ow. Okay. So well, caller, one last question before I hang up on you.
Okay. All right.
The Fresno Nightcrawler. Real or not real?
Dude, real as fuck.
Oh, man. That's what I want to hear. Now, do you think it's interdimensional or an alien?
Probably interdimensional, because, like...
Wrong. The last person that sent me an email said they were an alien, so obviously it's got to be an alien. All right, so we're going to go to another song now. We're going to play A Moment by Pex, P-E-X. Happy Valentine's Day, East Coast. World. People that celebrate. That was a moment by Pex. We're having a fun time tonight on Nick the Rat Radio. We're talking about the Fresno Nightcrawlers. First we found out they were interdimensional. Now we're finding out that they're alien. There's a lot to know about them. But the one thing you have to know is that Nick the Rat Radio is... There are advertisements. But it's also user supported. But since user support is always going to be low, because if I ever said, hey, User support is way too high. Stop giving me money, then I'm not going to get money. So I'm going to say it's really low. But, you know, I love the people that do support me. You know who you are. And thank you so much. And I just want to say that if you do support me, you are my Valentine. And if you don't support me, I have to play this commercial because of you.
After a long, hard day at work, and then you come home, and there's your woman, spread eagle on the couch. You know what you have to do, but you want to make sure you do it right. The Dark Sewer Network wants to help you. They bring you the best things in the world. They bring you Nick the Rat Radio. They bring you all the crazy shit the scientists make down in the sewer. And now, introducing the new top-of-the-line Dark Sewer Space Condoms. Yes, the Dark Sewer scientists are now using space-age technology, so your jizz stays protected and disease-free. Have sex with aliens, zombies, gods, or other humans. Your pick. These space condoms will give you an O-face, more explosive than the Challenger. For $69.99, it's almost a great fit, especially for one spaceman spiffy. But his Saturn V is bigger than anything I've ever seen. Give us a call now at 917-719-5923 and order yourself a box of Dark Sewer space condoms. Because if you don't, somebody else will. And then they're going to have sex with your girlfriend. Friend, wife, partner. Don't make the same mistake as me. Order now, only through the Dark Sewer Network.
Oh my God, Jimmy, who taught you how to do that? That's disgusting.
I learned it from you, Dad. All right, I learned it from you.
Parents who fap have children who fap.
That was something. You know, it's Valentine's Day. We should let's do another little quip about love.
Can anyone live with Eartha Kitt?
That's not for me to decide. Not for someone who decides to live with me to decide. Not for me.
But are you willing to compromise within a relationship?
To compromise? What is compromising? Compromising for what? Compromising for what reason? To compromise for what? To compromise. What is compromise?
If a man came into your life, wouldn't you want to compromise?
Stupid. A man comes into my life and I have to compromise? You must think about that one again. A man comes into my life and you have to compromise for what? For what? For what? A relationship is a relationship that has to be earned, not to compromise for. And I love relationships. I think they're fantastic. They're wonderful. I think they're great. I think there's nothing in the world more beautiful than falling in love. But falling in love for the right reason. Falling in love for the right purpose. Falling in love. Falling in love. When you fall in love, what is there to compromise about?
Isn't love a union between two people? Or does Eartha fall in love with herself?
I think if you were to think about it in terms of analyzing, yes, I fall in love with myself and I want someone to share it with me. I want someone to share me with me.
Has that happened?
Bye, Waylon! Bye! Many, many times. In many ways.
Uh, Voicemail.
Hello, yeah, this is Marty. I'm calling you from the East Coast. I don't really want to give you too much information, but the Fresno Nightcrawler, if I recall, this is a type of insect, a really expensive one to go fishing with, right? It likes to actually, it drinks alcohol. It's kind of like a barfly, but it's really, it's just a moocher, isn't it? It's a big old moocher insect that people like to go fishing with usually at night to catch the big trout, right? This is the Fresno Nightcrawler. I don't really know too much about it because I don't go fishing, so I guess I'll leave you with that. All right, I gotta go. Bye.
No, it's not a fishing tool, a tool to fish with. That's not what it is. No more voicemails. Let's go to another song over here. Let's change it up. Play a lot of synthwave music. Ooh, look at that. I just got another follow by Doadenum. I wonder who this person is. They're new. I wonder how Doadenum found my show. How'd you find me, Doadenum? We're going to listen to Travis Rinker music, Surrounded by Trees.
Owls are not what they seem.
Now, you know, you're getting used a lot on the Nick Durant show.
I am?
Yeah.
Wait, like clips?
Yeah.
Oh, I haven't listened in a while.
Nick the Rat is great.
Oh, I know. The show's fantastic in the sewer.
No, that's what you're saying on the show.
Oh. Well, let's help him out then. Hold on a second. Let's see if we can make it work for Nick. All right, we'll give him one jingle and then we can move on.
Nick the Rat is great in the sewer.
Yeah, you can use that.
Whoa. Surrounded by trees. Travis Rinker music. Wait a second. Valentine's Day? Valentine's Day? Really? Okay. Hear that Earth Kit thing there? We got a lot of Valentine's Day clips here. Trust me, we're not done. We're not done with the Fresno. I almost said forensic. Nightcrawler. We're not done with you. We got more to come. I have theories. I have thoughts. I have opinions. But what does Charles Bukowski think about love? If you know who Charles Bukowski is, you already know.
What's your definition of love?
Love? It's kind of like, you know, you see a fog in the morning when you wake up before the sun comes out. It's just there a little while and then it burns away.
Really?
Absolutely.
It burns away?
Yeah. Quickly. It's just, love is a fog that burns with the first daylight of reality.
What was that, Bukowski? Probably not even saying his name right. But hey, you know, what are you gonna do? Are you gonna tell me I'm wrong? And they're silk, by the way, if you want to know. Okay, we're gonna look. Maybe we should play another clip. Let's play something that's so chaotic. Let's play. You know who had an opinion on love? Martin Luther King, not skiing cows. I don't know what you're talking about, Oztunden.
What happened is that some of our philosophers got off base. And one of the great problems of history is that the concepts of love and power have usually been contrasted as opposites, polar opposites, so that love is identified with a resignation of power and power with a denial of love. It was this misinterpretation that caused the philosopher Nietzsche, who is the philosopher of the will to power, to reject the Christian concept of love. It was the same misinterpretation which induced Christian theologians to reject Nietzsche's philosophy of the will to power in the name of the Christian idea of love. Now, we got to get this thing right. What is needed is a realization that power without love is reckless and abusive, and that love without power is sentimental and anemic. Power at its best. Power at its best is love, implementing the demands of justice, and justice at its best is love correcting everything that stands against love.
Silk Spannies. That was Martin Luther King talking about power and love. I should probably do some math right now, really quick. Let's do 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Oh. My phone is blown up. It looks like an email. Is it a donation? I always love when a donation comes in when I'm doing the show. No, it's not a donation. Greetings, Sewer Boy. That's me, I guess. I'm Sewer Boy. I heard you like gaming. Do you play Apex Legends? I'll whoop your ass in it. You probably suck. By the way, yes. I do play Apex Legends. And yes, it is trendy right now. And sadly, it is on Origin. Fuck EA. EA could suck a giant horse dick. It's a good game, though. If you like shooting games, speed, violence, and momentum. Yeah. Play it. It's still fucky, yeah. Just don't give them any money. They already got paid. We should do another gas blast, because that was a salty gas blast. Alright, let's see here. In the morning, Nick the Rat, do you find it strange when kids give their parents Valentine's Day cards? Isn't that implying they want to sleep with them? What do you think about that? I don't think about that. That's a weird question, and you should feel bad. If your kid gives you a Valentine's Day card, they love you. They don't know what you're trying to say. I don't get bodied in Apex Legends, ex-paladin. Just because you're a subscriber on Twitch doesn't mean I have to listen to your bullshit, okay? I'll stream it this week. I'll stream a whole bunch of it this week, okay? If you want to watch me play some shooting 'em up games, I'll have fun this week. Tune into my Twitch channel. Okay, let's get back to the show here. You know, we only played one Zindu. Let's play Zindu number two. Zindu two. Zindu two. Zindu two 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 two.
Zindu, the Dark Sword Network News. Hey, everybody, it's Valentine's Day coming up tomorrow. That's great, isn't it? Well, it wasn't great for some fucking lions at the London Zoo. These Sumerian tigers, they were trying to get them to fuck. They brought this male cat in. Who was, he was like, fuck it, he was like twice her age or something. He was like 12, she was 7. They only lived to be about 15. I don't know why they're waiting so long to get these cats together. They should maybe raise them together at birth to get them to fuck. So anyway, the zoo put them in the cages next to each other for a little while. They were like, hey, they played some sexy music, maybe a little Pat Benatar, a little saxophone or something. Well, as soon as that they were like, these cats are ready to go. This is going to be a beautiful time. It's going to be beautiful. It's going to be love and flowers and fucking hearts and fireworks. So they opened the cage door. They let them mingle. And the man cat, using his male toxicity, I don't know. This is joking this somewhere. He ate her. He basically just fucking ate her. The people at the zoo, they were like, yeah, we banged on pots and pans. We squirted them with super soakers and all that. But it didn't really work out. Didn't work out. Why didn't they have the sniper rifles with the darts that make you pass out, you know? First, inject him with a little Viagra, get him horny. If that doesn't work out, he starts to chew on her face. Shoot him with a tranquilizer dart. But no, I guess they weren't planning too far ahead. They were too optimistic. If you ever put me in a cage with a giant cat, I'm going to kill you first. I don't care. Ooh, these exotic creatures. Ooh, I can pet a fucking exotic creature. This is great. No, you can get eaten. You get bit once and you're done for. It's over. Why would you even really want to put up with that? I don't know. The article, this is a New York Times article. It later goes on to talk about the zoo and how there's a fire and there's missing meerkats and they're presumed dead. I really don't know what the hell that's about. But anyway, life's a bitch and love's a bitch. And, make sure you find somebody that's not going to eat you. Anyway, that's Zindu. Happy Valentine's Day. Peace, love, and light. Yeah, bye.
Peace, love, and light there, Zindu. Peace, love, and light, brother. You know what it's all about. Now I got Apex Legends on the mind. I'm addicted to video games, I think. I have dreams of it now. I've been detoxing from the marijuana, and it's been giving me very strange dreams, and I've been playing a lot of Apex Legends, and I've been having a lot of dreams of flying through the air and bing, bing, bing. Let's continue on with the show. What is this? This is weird. We just got another emergency email in here. All right, let me read this here. Let me get serious. This is not a joke. Hello, Nick. Both of the previous sightings reported are totally false. Really? About the Fresno Nightcrawler or the caramel creamy thighs? Let's see here. I am part of the Monachi tribe of the native people of Fresno, California. The creature they speak of are true, though. Our ancestors... Wow, this is weird. So now it's not an alien. It's not an interdimensional being. It's an Indian... It's like an ancient Indian creature? Oh, hold on. I need another drink for this one. We live in crazy times, people. Scientist... Skeptics and Indians could email you their opinion about stuff. It's crazy times. Okay, where was I? It's a really important email. Our ancestors worshipped these creatures. They would come out of the floor and mill the land for us. Our ancestors worshipped these creatures. They would... Okay, all right, just read that sentence. Hold on. I'm a little drunk. There once was a time when thousands of them would come out and walk up and down the fields, plowing them for us before returning back into the earth. We would call them night crawlers because they would come out at night only. Wow. So these night crawlers are definitely night crawlers. And they seem to be from California. But now they're from the earth? They're like golems or something? This is weird. Let's see here. Let me find out where I was. There was thousands of them. They would walk up and down the fields, plowing them before returning back into the earth. We would call them night crawlers, but they would come out at night only. We built giant wooden idols of them to let them know we love them. Oh, so they sound like good creatures. Really? Okay, I'll just read it. I'm gonna read it verbatim sounds like something a furry would do. They'd furbait them. We think after Monsanto came along and poisoned our lands, it killed most of them off. They are usually around 5 feet tall, and their skin was wood-like. They now cover themselves in white sheets to protect themselves from the chemicals in the soil. When they resubmerge themselves. Oh, okay, I see. So Monsanto poisoned the soil. They wear the white sheets. When they go back into the soil, they're protected. My great grandfather has a recording of them when they were in their more natural state. I've attached it to this email. Your show... I love this email to this point. Your show is questionable, but you seem noble. Signed, Esadoa. I usually don't read the name, but that seems like it's a... Let's load up this clip. Let's see what they sound like. Before. I heard it. That was weird. Did you hear? I heard like clacking of like metal leg, wooden leg, not metal, wooden. That sounded very wooden clacking. Let's play it one more time. They do seem to move like that noise. This actually sounds maybe more legit than the other two people. Maybe they're right. These are creatures that came from the earth. Let's listen to one more time. This is chilling. This is... Oh, dear God. That... That really hit me in a weird spot. And hopefully this song hits you in a weird spot. The Sick Notes with Tainted Love. I'll be right back. Where's the little boy's room?
Sometimes I feel I've got to run away, I've got to get away from the pain that you drive into the heart of me. The love we share, it seems to go nowhere, and I've lost my light. Provides our center and I can't sleep at night. Once I ran to you, now I run from you. This tainted love you've given, I give you all a boy could give you.
Take boxes, but that's not nearly.
Tainted love. Now I know I've got to run away, I've got to get away. Don't really want any more for me to make things right. You need someone to hold you tight, and you'll think love is to pray, but I'm sorry, I don't play that way. Once I ran to you, now I run from you. This tainted love you've given, I give you all a boy could give you.
Take my tears, but that's not nearly.
Take it long. Take it long. Take it long. Take it long. Don't touch me, please. I cannot stand the way you tease. I love you though you hurt me so. Now I'm gonna pack my things and go.
Take it long.
Tainted love. By the Sick Notes. Welcome back, everybody. We are having a good time here in the sewer. It is fucking Valentine's Day. In 20 more minutes, it's going to be Valentine's Day for, like, people an hour before me, an hour after me. Should be a good time for them. Valentine's Day is a very special day. There's a lot of love involved. Let's hear... Abraham Twersky talk about love.
Love is a word that in our culture has almost lost its meaning. There's a very interesting story about the Rebbe of Kotsk, who came across a young man who was clearly enjoying a dish of fish that he was eating. And he said, young man, why are you eating that fish? And the young man says, because I love fish. He says, oh, you love the fish. That's why you took it out of the water and killed it and boiled it. He said, don't tell me you love the fish. You love yourself. And because the fish tastes good to you, therefore you took it out of the water and killed it and boiled it. So much of what is love, right, is fish love, right? And so, young couple falls in love. Young man and young woman fall in love. What does that mean? That means that he saw in this woman someone who he felt could provide him with all of his physical and emotional needs. And she saw in this man somebody she feels that she can write. That was love, right? But each one is looking out for their own needs. Right? It's not love for the other. The other person becomes a vehicle for my gratification. Too much of what is called love is fish love. Right? An external love is not on what I'm going to get, but what I'm going to give. We had an ethicist, Rabbi Dessler, who said, the people make a serious mistake in thinking that you give to those whom you love. And the answer is, the real answer is, you love those to whom you give. Right? And his point is, if I give something to you, I've invested myself in you, right? And since self-love is a given, everybody loves themselves, now that part of me has become in you, right? There's part of me in you that I love, right? So true love is a love of giving, not a love of receiving.
There you go. True love is giving it, not receiving. You're on the receiving end, you're... you're doing it wrong, apparently, to that guy right there. 917-719-5923 is the phone number. We're taking calls, we're taking voicemails, we're taking emails. Looks like we have more voicemail. Let's play this here voicemail right here. Oh, crap. Actually, I gotta play two voicemails.
Hello, Nick. It's Alan Watt. It seems, well, first let me clear this up. It's Alan Watt, not Alan Watts.
Oh.
You confuse me for the philosophist. I am a Scottish-Canadian conspiracy theorist who's been publicized on Alex Jones. You see, Nick, the Club of Rome told you to do this. I know all about your connection to the Club of Rome. You will not send me to the FEMA camps. You will not! Well, can you please send your viewers to buy my DVDs?
No.
And boner pills? It'd be much appreciated.
No.
All right, Nick. Have a happy Valentine's Day. I'll send you some male hookers from the Club of Rome.
Do that, please, yeah.
Or female hookers. Whichever you prefer. 1414. Out.
I'll take either or. We have another voicemail from the great, the wonderful, the beautiful, the sexy, Tony Wolf.
Hello, Nick the Rat. This is Tony, Tony Wolf, Wolf. Tony, Tony Wolf, Wolf. Yeah, this is Tony Wolf calling the Nick the Rat radio show. It's been too long, man, since I called in to your most excellent radio show.
Thank you, Tony.
You know, I know, are you still recording in the sewers?
Yeah.
Sometimes we would hear the droplets of water in the sewers. But let me know if you've moved to a new fancy location, you know.
Still down the sewer.
A rat of your stature. He deserves to record in luxury. That's what I'm saying. You deserve the best, man.
Thank you, man.
You deserve to record in, like, Jimi Hendrix's former studio in the East Village, you know. I'm gonna contact my people. I'm going to see if I can help you out there. I know your show deals with the paranormal. Have you had any psychic inclinations lately? Have you had any impressions that you've gotten? Psychic messages from the other dimensions? Psychic messages from other frequencies. I think when we tune into other frequencies, we start to get messages, you know, from other dimensions. And then things kind of sound like different. They might sound like... you know, they might sound like that. I don't know. What do you think, Nick? Tell me what you think. I'm Tony Wolf.
you don't know who Tony Wolf is, look him up. He's a fun little character actor in New York City. I had some beers with him. He's also a really great artist. Does a comic about Greenpoint. Greenpoint of View, he called it. Great name. He nailed it. Greenpoint is, it's kind of hip though. It's a little hip. Whoa. We have a call coming in. Hello, caller.
Hello, Nick the Rat. I was inspired, so I called you back. You know what I'm going to do?
I inspired you?
You did. You always inspire me. Sorry, I was breathing. Anyway.
On your own. You don't need a DM to breathe for you.
You want an ad-lib story? I'm going to do it right on the spot.
Do it.
I'm like a rapper, but I'm so white that instead of rapping, I tell a fairy tale.
Well, you know, fairy tales are... There was a really cool quote from some guy that... The guy that wrote H.L. Lewis, the guy that wrote Alice in Wonderland.
Mm-hmm.
He, like, wrote it to his niece, and he was like, by the time I finish writing this, you're not going to be a kid anymore, and you're not going to want to read fairy tales, but by the time you want to reread them, I'll be too old. And it was just a weird little thing he said, but it was cool. It was inspiring. Anyway, I don't want to take away from your story time.
Okay, here we go.
Do it.
It's going to come off the top of my head. I'm a blank slate right now. It's just going to be my imagination. Let's see. It was 2 a.m. Melvin was out wandering. He had too much to drink. A week beforehand, he'd been fired from his job, and he had to move in with his mother. And with what little money he had left, he spent it on booze. This was a particularly heavy night of drinking, and he decided to wander about. But once he started wandering, he had no idea where he was going. He went in and out of consciousness, although his body still moved. And at a moment of clarity, he found himself in the middle of a field. Whose field was this, he wondered. For you see, he lived in a city where there weren't very many fields. And yet somehow, he stumbled upon this one. He looked around to see if there was anything around. And all he saw was a house. To his left, and nothing but field. Instead of walking towards the house, he decided to keep walking into the field. But what he thought he saw... Hold on, that didn't make sense. Grammatically incorrect. He thought he saw something coming up towards him, but when he rubbed his eyes, the thing disappeared. And he decided to keep walking. Stumbling about, mumbling to himself quietly, thinking about all the regrets of his life, how he lost his job. The company that he was with suddenly lost all of its funding and they had to lay him off after he'd been there for only 5 years. The economy was hard then. And it took him a long time to find this job in the first place. But then, as he was in the middle of all of his regret thinking, he saw something in the distance. It had impossibly long legs, and it walked as though it were on stilts. It didn't appear to have a head, didn't appear to have a torso. And was walking right towards him. Step, step, step. Although he was drunk, he could still feel fear. And he turned around and he tried to run. But he could not run because he was incredibly uncoordinated and he fell down. And he could hear the thing coming towards him in the field. Step, 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 that crunch when you step. It doesn't make a step sound. It makes a crunch sound. Okay, hold on.
Gather yourself. You're doing a great job. You're doing a good job. I'm totally in the mood. I'm feeling it.
Okay. Step. Crunch. Crunch. Well, what's the name again? Melvin. Melvin scrambled up to his feet. But then he tripped again. And he started to crawl. He was panicking. But he was so drunk, he couldn't get his brain to help him escape from danger. Crunch. Crunch. And then he was stepped on. And then there was nothing. Okay.
So it stepped on him and crunched him? Oh, hold on one second. Hold on. Let me... I had a cool effect on your voice there. It sounded like you were echoing.
No.
No, it was good. I liked it. It was a little too much. So did it get bigger? How did it stepped on him? It crunched him?
I don't know. I just felt like I wanted to stop somehow, so I was like, I'll just have him crush him so I can stop.
And he was crunched and stepped on.
The end. But yeah, I don't know. That was kind of fun.
I hope he had a good, I hope he has crunch insurance.
He doesn't. And he's like poor now, and he lives with his mom because he lost his job and he's spending all his money on booze. He's depressed, man.
That is pretty depressing. That was a depressing story.
Yeah, I know. Yeah, that's really sad. Why did I think of something so depressing?
I don't know. What's wrong with you? What do you have? Do you have issues or something? Like the Fresno Nightcrawler. He's a good dude, apparently.
Yeah, got crushed by a Nightcrawler. Because this guy, well, Fresno, man, you have no idea how bad it is in California right now. It's so bad.
Have you ever been to Fresno? What is the state of Fresno?
I used to live right next to fucking Fresno, and it was awful.
What's wrong with Fresno? Is it like too expensive for avocados out there?
I don't know.
Did you ever hear of Caramel, California? Caramel? Caramel, California?
Caramel Valley? I've never been to Caramel, California.
Caramel
Valley's near where I live. Yeah.
It sounds fake. It sounds like a fake place. Yeah.
Could be.
Fake geography.
I don't know. There's Caramel Valley, but it's just part of San Diego, though, so it's not nowhere near Northern California.
No, we're talking about, I think this all is taking place in Southern California. This is a Southern California creature. But why does he come? Where does he come from?
I don't know. Maybe he's just like a meth head, man. Like, everybody's like, oh, no, it's a monster. And it's just like, he's just this lost meth head, just like cruising.
Could be. A cruising meth head stepping on people.
Yeah. I mean, that's probably all it is. Like, he probably was like, you know, no, that's mean. I shouldn't say that.
No, don't say it if it's mean. Have you seen a Russian Doll, the TV show on Netflix?
Yeah, her name's Nadia. I was like, bitch, we got the same name.
Because there's like the homeless guy without shoes in there. Maybe he... you haven't hit that point yet?
Let's see. I got to the point where she like dropped her cat while she was like next to the water. She's like,
And she like vanished. That was like episode 3. Do you remember the homeless guy that was rolling around on the fence?
Mm-hmm.
He loses his shoes. He might be the Fresno Nightcrawler.
Yeah. Maybe. Could be.
Perhaps.
Could be.
Perhaps.
All right. Well,
is there anything
I've been taking a lot of airtime.
Is there anything you'd like to say to hashtag Sewer Chat?
Hashtag Sewer Chat, help me write my book. That'd be cool. I'm going to put a...
You can't ask for help from the chat to write your book, because then who's going to pay who? This is going to be a really questionable situation you're in. We have, let's have a George Carlin talk about love.
Here is, I'm sure, something positive we can talk about, George.
All right.
Somebody sends a fax, and they're really right. They say even the most cynical person frequently, and you're in that position now, would have some words to say about love. I mean, you're obviously you're newly in love.
Yes.
And you're plunging, tumbling right into it again. And so you must feel pretty positive about that.
Well, the only things that I really believe in, because I don't believe in my country, I don't believe in religion and God and the institutions that man has made, I don't believe in commerce, but I believe in friendship, romantic love, and family, of course, which is bound into
sure.
friendship. Yes, I believe heartily, and that goes back to my affection for individual existence and individuals and the life of the sole person. It's as I say, when they get into numbers larger than four or five, even sometimes a group of two
yeah.
will alter how a person is. You heard a woman will say, well, Mike's not the same when he's with those guys, or the guys will say, well, now that he's got married, he's a different guy.
Right.
People surrender something. That's why when a good love affair comes along, when a great love happens, it's because the two people don't have to surrender too much of themselves to make a new unit. And that's what I'm lucky enough to think I have found. And I agree with that fact sender.
He does. He does. All right, we had a whole bunch of stuff in the whatnots, so we should maybe play some more songs. It's Valentine's Day. Let's play... Oh, boy. This one's a little iffy. Makina did a Beach Cumbia edit of Goate, somebody that I used to love. Hey, they all can't be winners. Wieners. I don't hate it though. Otherwise, I wouldn't add it. 1 a.m. in the morning, everybody. I love you all.
So when we found that we could not make sense, well, you said that we would still be friends. But I'll admit that I was glad that was over.
Abrupt ending. Good night, Cyborg Dave, if you're leaving. Show's almost over. It's kind of late. It's 1 in the morning. That was Goaty, Goatsy. That was Goatsy, How Far Can You Spread Your Butthole? Somebody That I Used to Know by Makina. M-A-K-I-N-A. All the music you're hearing tonight is all on SoundCloud. You can find it through my webpage if you know where to click. But apparently my webpage is also illegal. It doesn't have the security thing on it, but don't worry, because anything that you do on my webpage doesn't really fucking matter. If you click donate, you go to PayPal. They're secure. Oh boy. I am pretty toasty. Do we have anything else here? What is this? Looks like we have more email. Hold on 1 second. Yeah, we got more email. Gas blast. I could still read. Just because it's blurry doesn't mean the show can't go on. Hi, Nick. The Fresno Nightcrawler is real. I saw it once in my backyard. I screamed and called for my parents. You little pansy. Fresno Nightcrawler is so cute looking. I was living in the house in California at the time. I guess she meant their house. My mom was a little bit older, and when she came down and saw it waddling through the yard, she had a heart attack and passed away. I'm sorry for your loss. That's horrible. After calling 911 for her, the creature was gone. I now walk the streets at night with a shotgun. And if I ever see that fucker again, well, you know what's going to happen. Dirty boy style? Come on. It wasn't really the... It was your mom's ticker, not the thing. All right, we got more voicemails. 917-719-5923. We have a lot more voicemails. Let's play a whole bunch of VMs. Yeah, we're going to play a whole bunch of VMs right now. Why not?
Yes, this is Captain Jolo Picard calling Nick the Rat. Surely your last name is something other than simply Rat, that species.
That's Rat. That's it.
That we're all most familiar with. You may have heard that Paramount Pictures is currently developing a new television show about me, Captain Jean-Luc Picard, and I believe they're simply going to call it Picard. It's quite pleasing to me, being Jean-Luc Picard. And this show is going to take us to some very unique places as we see where has Jean-Luc been, where has he gone. Is he an ambassador? Is he enveloped in a new mystery, perhaps? Is he listening to Nick the Rat? Perhaps he is. Perhaps Jean-Luc Picard is embroiled in a fascinating psychic phenomenon. Perhaps Jean-Luc Picard is picking up waves, sound waves, frequency waves, from another dimension, from a portal into the sewer of Nick the Rat. So watch for that now, coming soon, to CBS All Access, Picard, co-starring Nick the Rat and the sewer. Watch for it, wait for it, engage.
You gotta love it when Jean-Luc Picard gives you a call. That's when you know you're kind of special. 917-719-5923. We still have some voicemails. Let's listen to a couple of them. The show must go.
Hello, Nick.
Oh.
Down Watt again. I'm back. I just wanted to tell you that I love Zindu. I'm actually in the cult of Zindu. I love a soybean orgies.
Whoa.
And I don't believe in David Icke. Well, I believe he is a person, but I don't believe in the lizard people. Or is that just what the Club of Rome wants you to think? Think about it, Nick. Think about it. May God or your gods with you. Out. 1414.
What is this 1414? I don't know what he's trying to say with this 1414. It looks like we have one more voicemail. Let's play this last voicemail. 917-719-5923. Let's see what this one's about.
Hey, Nick. Oh, this is Kyle's dad. I was just wondering if you had a Valentine's Day date. Because I dipped my balls in chocolate. I wonder if you'd stick them in your mouth. My poor boy Kyle's dead now. Thanks for killing him off. He was a little douchebag sucking me into mama's drive all of our money. But now I'm free, so I want you to suck my balls. I hope you have a great show, you little rat bastard piece of shit. Bye.
Kyle, was that really Kyle's dad? Kyle, was that your dad? It's too bad the dead can't speak. Jesus Christ. No, I will not put your chocolate-covered balls in my mouth, Kyle's dad. It's just wrong. We're coming towards the close of the show, which is always a good sign. Let's play another song really quick. This one's Enjoy the Silence. Hey, happy Valentine's Day, everybody. You know what? Let's play some more stuff about love. How about a quick Richard Pryor story about love? And then we'll play a song, Enjoy the Silence, remixed by Bully Space.
to be bullshitting, you know, but when you get them feeling somebody touches that shit inside you, that shit be fucking with you. When they make you mad, and women, I don't give a fuck. Y'all can be so cool about turning a motherfucker off. You love when a motherfucker be in love with you, because you can be some nasty bitches. When the motherfucker, darling, please don't let me, just give me the, oh God, are you calling again? God, Richard, please, just don't do this to yourself. I mean, why don't you go home and bathe or something like that? Just don't call here anymore. Just a minute, John. How can women be so cool though when you angry? Don't you tell me, I love you, don't you see? Yes, dear, I'm going for a walk. A walk? I want to fight! One night I left the house about 137 times. I did. I just said, fuck you! And then I'd have to come back like, you forget your keys. You ever leave and forget your keys? Bitch, yeah, motherfucker! Yeah, uh-huh. Bleed that shit. Yeah. You'll see. Oh, shit. Then you got to go back in the house. Why come your old lady looks so good after you've been away for a while? Right? You ever, like, get your heart broke like men here? You ever had your heart broke like men don't get their... Women get their heart broke, they cry. Men don't do that shit. Men hold that shit in like it don't hurt. Walk around and get hit by trucks. Say, didn't he see that truck? He said, motherfucker, he wouldn't have seen a 747. Because his heart was broken. Right? I mean, there's a feeling getting your motherfucking heart broke. It's like, I don't know. It's like men cannot graduate till a woman breaks your fucking heart. That is your diploma. It either kill you or make you fat. I'm talking about that heartache where your motherfucking heart be, ooh, hurting and shit, and you can't even listen to music. Shit remind, like Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer.
It reminds me of my leg. She got a nose just like Rudolph.
Richard Pryor, yep.
And you go out with other women when you love. You go out with other women, don't mean shit, right? You go out with other women and they talk and they go, you hear their voice, they go, what is this bitch talking about? Why don't she just shut the fuck up? She ain't saying shit. Because it's hard to reestablish yourself with other people once you've been with a partner for a long time, right? Especially if you get a good woman that you really be in love with. And usually it's the man that fucks up. We fuck up, right? Then we can't find them motherfuckers no more. Right? And when you can't find her no more, it look like she get better. Every time you see her, she be beautifuler with some other motherfucker that look good. I be going, I want to kill everybody. Everybody in the world. That's how you end up in penitentiary, Jack. A lot of people in penitentiary done killed their old ladies and shit. And boyfriends and shit like to just flip out. I don't give a fuck.
That was Richard Pryor right there. Aw, man. And guess who's coming up next? Zindu!
Hey, everybody, it's Zindu, giving you a little news about money, because, hey, why the hell not? You know, we talk about science and love and sex and murder. Why not money, okay? So the guy on Shark Tank, Kevin O'Leary, he's got to be really smart because he's on TV, right? Well, he says that he's got the top three stupid things millennials waste their money on. He says right here, the number one thing is coffee. He says, you buy a cup of coffee, $4 a day, you do that twice a day, it's $8, it's like $1,100 per year or something, just in coffee alone. All right, whatever, sure. Second number thing, he says, is shoes. He's like, you buy too many shoes, you got five pairs of shoes, it's way too many goddamn shoes you buy, millennials are stupid. And the number three things is jeans. You buy too many jeans, they're like $60 a pair of jeans. You only need like three pairs of jeans. Hell, I only have got like one pair, it's got holes in it. I just wear them every day, I don't wash them either, because jeans, you just Febreze them, you smell like a brand new person. But I think I think that this guy's got it wrong. All right, so the top three things millennials, I think, that they're wasting their money on is, number one, drugs. Drugs is, they're great and all, but I'm sure, this includes alcohol, because, you know, you might go out and you spend $4 for a cup of coffee once a day, but you go to a bar, you're spending, like, most bars, unless you go to a nice dive one that I go to, it's going to be like $10 a beer. And you're not just drinking one beer. God, no. You're going to drink like four or five of those motherfuckers. That's like $50 right there. Just fucking get a little buzz going on. And by that time, you're going to spend like another fucking $50 and more beer. It's alcohol and drugs. You know, just stay at home. Make your own. Grow a weed plant. Fuck it. And make some moonshine in your toilet bowl. You'll be good to go. The number two thing that I think millennials will waste their money on is school. Everybody that goes to school, when they come out, guess what? They're just in debt. They don't get jobs. They don't even care about what they went to school for. If you really have a love and a passion, you're going to do it anyway. If you fucking love being a doctor, guess what? You're going to be a doctor. Well, maybe you should go to school for that because you need a license for it. But if you're going to be doing something else like fucking computers or something, like not fucking computers, but maybe like coding, blah, 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 you can just go to YouTube. Just go to YouTube.com, type in like how to do some shit, and you can fucking do it. Like, a month later, you get a job, you fucking just show up to work. The main thing for work is if you wake up and you show up every morning, you probably got a job for life. You're good to go. And the number three thing that fucking millennials waste their money on, I'm just going to come out and say it, is love. It's love. You guys are all tricked and fooled by the corporate America. You go out and it's like, ooh, it's Valentine's Day. I got to take out this person to this restaurant that's like, ooh, it's like $150 just to fucking eat a piece of fish or something. You're wasting your money. Just stay at home, fucking, you get a fish, cook that up. It's like $10. You'd be good to go. You put that in her face. You're good to go. You just love stuff. It's way too much money. Flowers. Why girls like flowers? They just die. Are they death bringers? They just want death in their house? Like, oh, look at this. It looks great. It's death. Okay, ladies. I'm sorry, but, you're killing us. You're killing us guys out there. And you guys are just too stupid to see it. Anyway, Zindu, and that was just the money tips and all that shit. You know, invest your money into like a 3% something or other. Maybe throw it in the stock market for a 5% something or other. I don't know. Either way, we're $22 trillion in debt. Yeah, so basically money's not real because we're living in debt. And debt is negative money, and basically, yeah, the money's not real, and we're ruled by slavers. Zindu, out.
Twitch is a graveyard. Yeah, it's that old Zindu. Wow. Let's listen to Enjoy the Silence. Remixed by FL Studios. Bully Space. That right there was Enjoy the Silence, remade by Bully Space. I'm going to end the show soon because, oh boy, oh boy. It's getting hard to do this, especially when I'm drunk over here. Wait a second. Do we have more voicemail? It looks like the voicemail box is empty. But it looks like other boxes are filled to the brim. Spewing over the top. Filled to the brim. Gas blast right here. Hi, Nick. The Fresno Nightcrawl is real. Sort of my backyard. I screamed to them. No. Sorry. Okay. That was the old one. I think the Fresno Nightcrawler is a tuning force for our inner spirit. This is a weird email. The way it walks, talks to my soul. I've seen the video of them, and I can't stop thinking about how good it would feel if they were walking on my back. I feel ya. Maybe if we catch a few of them, we can open up a massage... we can open up massage parlors across the country. Do you think they give happy endings? Well, if they do, sign me up for one or two. I'll take two, please. Thank you very much. Wait. Wait a second. It looks like we just got another email that says emergency. Getting? No, it's been. Oh boy. Okay, we got another emergency email here. It's hard to read. Good evening. Sitting in my beanbag, smoking some weed, listening to your show, and I don't buy any of this shit. Oh, fuck you. One night in my room, I was laying down and I heard a noise in my closet. When I opened it, there it was. I saw the freaking Fresno Nightcrawler. Holy shit, that's scary. It's not an alien. It's not from the Earth. It's not interdimensional. It's a straight-up monster. It thrashed around my closet and got tangled up in a pair of my underwear. My panties. It gave me a wedgie and it made my butt cheeks stick out. No. It got tangled up in a pair of my underoos and fell. It bumped into me and knocked me out. When I woke up, it was gone. There was just a mess in my room on my floor. I know that feeling. I checked my phone and it turned out I did record it though. You will find it attached to this email. Stay cool, brother. And I can't read your name because I don't do that. All right, looks like we have another recording of this thing. Let's listen to this.
I've been hearing some scary stuff in my room lately. I don't know what it is, but like, it's been freaking me out. Like, hold on, I don't know. But like, yeah. What the? I know you guys didn't hear that. What the hell, dude? What the freak? What the hell? What the hell? What the freak, dude? What the hell? Free, what the? I gotta see what it is. Free. What the hell is?
What the hell?
Hello? Oh, what the fuck? What the hell?
Did you guys hear that? Wait, let me see if I can skip to the end of that there.
What the hell is?
It looks like it makes that noise.
Hello? Oh, what the fuck?
Holy shit. Alright. Fresno Nightcrawler, real, not real? Definitely real. Definitely real. After hearing that one. Ooh. This is more... We have more news. Hold on here.
Hello, everybody. This is Zindu, and this is... Nick the Rat Radio News. Let's see what we got here on CNN. This is... here we go. Bill Cosby in jail. Well... it's sort of like jail. Apparently, he doesn't have a cellmate. He exercises by himself. He doesn't have to spend time with the other inmates. So he's saying he's having a great time. Well, yeah, because he doesn't have to hang out with Ricky Rapo or Johnny, I'm gonna stab you in the throat, or Billy, I'll fucking shit on your chest while you're sleeping at night. You know, there's a lot of crazy people in jail. I've only been there a couple times, you know, because, you know, U.S. authorities don't really like a big, strong, handsome alien like myself just wandering the streets. They like to lock me up, but I always get out. Either way, yeah, he's there for 3 years for raping a lady because he knocked her out with some Jell-O, and he's having a good time. He's mentally strong. He's not eating any fucking coffee, apparently. Yeah, his wife doesn't visit him. He just talks to her on the phone. Oh, who cares about this? This guy's a jerk. He's a jerk. You shouldn't knock women out and have sex with them. And is he going to learn his lesson? Nah, but he probably hasn't knocked a woman out and had sex with them in years. So it's, I don't really think that prison's going to fucking, quote unquote, fix him. Probably death will in a couple more months or something. He's there for a while. He's pretty old. I don't know. Whatever. He used to make me laugh, and now he still makes me laugh. So I guess there's that. Anyway, this is Sindhu, and this is the Dark Sewer Network News.
It's harsh. man. Well, you know, it's now Valentine's Day for more than half the country. Maybe just half the country. So I just want to say thanks to everybody out there for supporting the show, supporting me, having a good time, calling me, leaving me voicemails, leaving me emails, leaving me messages, just adding content to the show. Everything I find it very exciting, and there's nothing wrong with being excited and having exciting times. That's Valentine's Day, baby. Let's listen to some more stuff about love and things like that.
Right. Well, it's so interesting to me. You know, one of the things too, which I learned in theater when I took theater for 6 weeks.
Yes.
One of the things I learned, which I found so cool, was that the Greeks put in their plays lots of discussions about bodily functions and sex. And the reason they did is they believed that by talking about it, released the demons of shame from their body. So, similarly, if I may take the high ground for dick joke's sake, that's kind of what I do. I mean, look, a lot of that is direct reaction to a fundamentalist Christian puritanical attitude that is shoved down our throat, which obviously keeps these secrets locked away and forms aberrant behavior. Not to say I'm not a pervert, I am. But what's the way to fucking recovery is
Bill Hicks, not denial.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
As opposed to being some guy who can't show his feelings or some guy who molests children.
Yeah.
You know, whatever it forms its aberration, or a guy who can't even love his wife, which I find so scary. And I'm so sick of hearing my friends get married, go, God, Bill, it really does change. It frightens the shit out of me.
Yeah.
I don't want it to change. And maybe I'm a total idealist, and maybe I'm going to burn out and fucking self-immolate one day, and that's fine, too. I don't care anymore.
Oh. So sad that he doesn't care anymore. I think the show's over. I think that's it. I think we made it to the end. We're at the end now. We could all finally finish. Yay. Happy Valentine's Day, everybody. The Fresno Nightcrawler. It's real. And it's coming. Because it's Valentine's Day. Have a good night, everybody. We're going to listen to one more song over here. I Would Do Anything for Love by Go Team Spirit. Thank you. Jason. You've met. I love you. Will you be my Valentine, Jason 13? No, I won't. Right now.
Here. I'll see you tomorrow.